Hey, what's up guys? This is Greg from ASUS, and I am at ASUS headquarters in Taiwan. And we're announcing a lot of great new hardware at the show, but one thing I'm really excited about is the ROG Zephyrus GX501 Ultra Portable Gaming Laptop. This is the first of a new generation of laptops utilizing the NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1080 with Max-Q technology. In order to cram such a high-powered GPU into a slim and light laptop like this, we had to totally rethink laptop cooling design. But before we get into the cooling and design features, why don't we quickly go over some of the specs. It's got an Intel Core i7-7700HQ CPU. The GPU is an NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1080. It's also available with a GTX 1070, 24GB of DDR4 memory at up to 2400MHz. 512GB PCIe Gen 3 NVMe M.2 SSD. It also features a 15.6-inch 1080p 120Hz G-Sync display. And it weighs less than 5 pounds. On the outside, it's got all the standard connections. We've got a headset jack, two USB 3.0, HDMI, power port. On the other side, we've got two more USB 3.0 ports and a USB Type-C connection for Thunderbolt and USB 3.1. The keyboard is positioned at the front of the chassis to allow for better cooling for the internal components and to offer more comfortable, familiar position when gaming. Has Aura RGB backlighting, so you can customize the color and dynamic lighting effects. It also features anti-ghosting with up to 30 key rollover, and they've been designed with 1.4 millimeters of travel for greater comfort and accuracy when typing or gaming. So now let's talk about the cooling. When you open the laptop, the bottom flexes to create 20% more open space for air circulation. This improves airflow by up to 40% and reduces temperatures by 20% when compared to conventional GPU cooling. This means that you could game for hours without the GPU throttling back and losing performance. All these features add up to make the ROG Zephyrus GX501 an incredible gaming powerhouse that's thin and light enough to take with you wherever you go. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this quick overview. We'll be doing a more in-depth review with benchmarks and all that a little bit later. So go ahead and subscribe to be notified for that. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.